Check one. How y'all doing?
Good.
It's good to be back here in Greenbelt with the Hillbilly Gypsies. We come from over the hills in West Virginia. We're going to play some various mix of bluegrass and old-time traditional music and original music. I'll just shut up and we'll get started here. Studio albums, and then Ben here on the fiddle has a couple of CDs available. We also have a few other products we'll tell you about later. Right now I'm going to tell you about a song. This is one that I wrote. It's a title track off of our last CD, like I said. This is called West Virginia Line.
My old West Virginia home. So when you pedal to the metal,
That's credited to Bill Monroe, who's the father of bluegrass music. But truth be known, Kenny Baker wrote this. He was Bill Monroe's fiddle player for many years, and several songs that are attributed to Bill Monroe, Kenny actually had a lot to do with the writing of the instrumental tunes. And I saw an interview with him before he passed away, and asked him how he felt about that. He said, you know, there's a lot of songs that you actually probably... you know, composed and wrote and all that, and somehow Bill, because he was the father of bluegrass, got the credit for it. Like, you know, how do you feel about that? And he said, well, you know, he lived on Bill's farm, no rent, got fed for years, you know. He said, you know, he put me up on his farm for several years, and he said, I never had to pay for a dime of anything while I was working with it. So he said, if that's all that came out of it, that was pretty fair trade. So anyway, truth be known, this is Kenny Baker's song called The Wheel Hoss.
I don't live at Trae's.
Thank you.
Levi Houston Sanders on this five string banjo over here.
When I think about an audience, I think there are so many different ways that it could go that could be great. You know, a great seated audience is really fun to play for, that's listening to every word, and we play a different body of work for that audience, and it brings out different parts of my playing. And that's really fun. But it's also fun to play to a really rowdy audience that you can hardly hear what you're doing. And like, there's fun in all of that. I think just being able to make a connection with some faction of the audience is what I'm always looking for. And I think people that have seen me perform, I kind of have two things that I do. And one is just total, like, if somebody's kind of standing off to the right of the stage, they'll think I'm staring them down the whole night, because I kind of lock into this, like, fiddle mode where my brain is, like, totally here and I'm lost in thinking my way around what I'm doing. But it looks like I'm totally engaging with the audience. And those people are really fun to talk to after. But there's always somebody, that's the fun part of being the side man, is I can kind of really be aware of what's going on, no matter what the audience is. And I think that's the beauty of performing, is really connecting with an audience and really tailoring yourself to the situation rather than wishing the situation was different.
Well, since we featured fiddle now, so I think it's time we should feature this dapper young fella right here on five-string banjo. This is Levi Houston Sanders, like I said. He's going to do a little bit of different style here. This is it's an old vaudeville number that a fella named Don Reno, I don't know if anybody's familiar with Don Reno. He was a banjo player back in the 1950s, and on from there he had a name for himself. Reno and Smiley TV show they had back in, I think it was sponsored by
Kroger.
The Kroger grocery store used to have a TV show, and Don Reno and Reno and Smiley, they were called, hosted that show. They were going Krogering all the time on that show. So. Anyway, Don Reno in the bluegrass world was unique as far as banjo players go. He had his own approach to the banjo. A little interesting historical fact. The great Earl Scruggs, who everybody knows in the bluegrass and banjo world, Earl Scruggs was Bill Monroe's banjo player for in the beginning of the bluegrass years. And interesting story, Don Reno was originally supposed to be the banjo player, and he got drafted for World War II, and he went, you know, overseas. And that was when Earl Scruggs showed up and totally changed Americana and that form of music. From that point on, Earl Scruggs was the guy, you know what I mean? Everybody, I always wonder what would have happened if Don Reno wouldn't have been drafted, what bluegrass would have become, you know, it would have been different. And you'll hear why here in a second. This here's, like I said, it's an old vaudeville tune that in the 50s Don Reno took and made into a banjo tune. And from that point on, with all of Don Reno's tunes, they became what was known as Reno songs. So we're gonna try that. This was called Whispering. Thank you. string band there. Levi, that last time around, you're playing really fast, and I'll bet you your fingers never left your hand, did they?
The Hillbilly Gypsies is a group of traveling musicians from West Virginia, and our goal is to spread awareness of bluegrass music and old-time traditions of the hills of Appalachia. Music is like, to me, is the equivalent of being a painter. My banjo is my brush, and what comes out of that banjo is what it's put on the canvas. For me, when I hold my banjo and play the banjo with these guys, it is like a third, it's an extension of my soul. And that's how I can talk to people and show people this wonderful art form of Appalachian hillbilly old-time bluegrass music. It's all the one giant genre. And it's an extension of my soul.
Anyway, I don't know the origins of this one. I just know that it's credited to A.P. Carter. So this is called the Foggy Mountain Top.
Thank you, Steve Foster. All right, here we go. I'm gonna lose any of my true love for a sleep. Rained all night the day I left, the weather it was dry. Sun so hot, froze to death. Susanna, don't you cry. Oh, Susanna.
About 6 years, I think. Just really enjoyed playing the bass with them.
It's got a lot of chords, and if you're one of these two guys, it's got a lot of notes. So I'm glad I'm not one of these two guys. I just give it a chunk of rhythm and keep it driving. So, this one here is called Limehouse Blues. All right, here we go. Let's do it. Thank you. Once again on five-string banjo. This, like I said, this is not a bluegrass tune. It's not an old-time tune. But it's one of these tunes that Jamie Lynn and I, we travel the world. For some reason, everywhere we go, people ask for this song. It's not Country Roads. We didn't get asked for that quite a bit. It's not wagon wheel. It's not wagon wheel. Great.
Well, we got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. Well, we've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. I'm going to Jackson.
Snowball Jackson.
See if I can.
Well, when I breeze into that city, my people gonna stoop and bow.
Song. We're going to try this one here. Like I said, this is a call and answer crowd participation song. All you need to know is two words. Some of y'all have been here and seen us before. This song's called Y'all Come. That's all you got to remember. I'll say, Y'all Come, and you'll say,
Y'all Come.
Preferably together and in time. But, try that again. Y'all Come.
Y'all Come.
That's better. I think we got it. Jamie and I played this in Spain, and I thought, how am I going to explain this to the Spaniards? Y'all come, you know? So we had a friend there, a mandolin player, he's Spanish, and we're going, his name's Crazy Richard, and he explained it really fast in Spanish, which they understood completely, and then he says, y'all come! And they were all, y'all come, like that. It's not that fast. It's slower, you know. But he had to explain to him what y'all meant, you know. It's not a Spanish thing, that word. So anyway, let's try it here again. Y'all come.
No, no.
They got it. Y'all come.
Y'all come.
You ready? Not at all.
Ready?
Me.
Yeah.
Vocal thing. You were asking about the description of the band. I would say that we're kind of a combination of traditional Appalachian old-time music and early era bluegrass music. We kind of like to merge the gap between the two, kind of where they cross lines and historically, and that's kind of where we sit. So.
Hi, I'm Jamie Lynn Buckner, and I sing lead and harmony vocals for the Hillbilly Gypsies. I'm one of the founding members. We've been around for about 16 years. We play bluegrass and old-time music. I play music in the band because nothing makes me happier than to see other people smile from something that I do for a living. So I'm a really lucky girl to be able to do this.
We're going to try this. This is West Virginia, my home. Backstep. Am I It's not really a dance move. I think it's supposed to come up with one. But the song's called the Clinch Mountain Backstep. And the backstep in the song is just a little timing part that's not natural to the ear. It's crooked. In old time music, we call it crooked tunes. It just means it's not standard, you know, chord changes. So there's a part in it, it's kind of like a hiccup, a little backstep in there. But if anybody wants to, you know, create the newest dance craze, you know, the Clinch Mountain Backstep. I got an uncle, and he's like 7 feet tall, I'm not kidding. And he's from a town called Greentown. And he likes to have a good time when he comes out to a show. He loves to dance, but he's 7 foot tall, and he's like uncoordinated. He just can't dance. I mean, he cannot dance. I mean, he's seven foot tall. I mean, it's just weird, you know? So anyway, he's from Greentown. We used to call it the Greentown Shuffle. That he had this weird, like, backwards thing he'd do. And then I was like, oh, he's doing a backstep. He's doing a backstep. You know, so we started calling the Greentown Backstep. So if you want to invent a move, man, this is your opportunity right here. Let's try it. Let's round back to it.
This is old John Hartford.
Buckner tune. Now, originally he called this song the Gold Rule Hornpipe, but it wasn't a hornpipe. A hornpipe is a particular type of fiddle tune. This is actually a waltz, so he eventually changed it to the waltz of the Golden Rule.
Right as we ended, it exactly hit 11 o'clock. It's like we were going to turn into a pumpkin or something.
I don't know.
No, I didn't know. I'll do one more. I'll do an acapella number for you. Lay down, my dear brother. Lay down and take your rest. Won't you lay your head upon your Savior's breast? Oh, I love you, oh, but Jesus loves you the best. And I bid you good night, good night, good night. Lay down, my dear brother, lay down and take your rest. Lay your head on your Savior's breast. Oh, I love you, oh, but Jesus loves you the best. And I bid you good night, good night, good night. Well, we bid you good night. Good night. I remember right well, good night. Good night. Good night. Lay down, my dear brother. Lay down and take your rest. Lay your head. Hillbillygypsies.com. And y'all come see us again. Thanks so much.